everyone. My name is Holly, and I'm an adult services librarian at the Westmont Public Library. And today I'm going to make a botanical scene in a frame. And I'm going to use a butterfly cutout, and I'm going to use some dried pressed flowers. So this is everything that we are going to use. So here is the frame. I'll go ahead and just move that out of the way. It came with this white background. I also have a brown background in there just to kind of make it a little bit more nature-y. So I'm actually going to use that. I've put the pressed flowers on the white background just as an example of how I kind of want it to look. So I'm just going to go based off of that. I'm going to go flower by flower onto the brown paper. I've got my butterfly cut out here. I've got just plain white glue. That's all you need. We don't really need a lot of it, so I put some in a little dish there, and then we've got some toothpicks, so we're going to use these to actually put the glue onto the flowers since they're so thin and delicate. So the first thing that I'm going to put on is the butterfly, because then I'm going to put the flowers on top of it and in front of it. So for that, I'm actually going to just put the glue straight on the butterfly. If you have a brush, a small paintbrush or anything, you can use that. I'm just going to put a thin layer. You don't need too much. And the white glue will dry clear, so when you're using it for the flowers, you don't really have to worry about it drying white or anything like that. It will dry clear. So we'll just press that down. And that's good and on there. And then I'm just going to start with the flowers. You can use tweezers to pick them up because they are so delicate. I'm actually just going to use my fingers. And then you're just going to take a little bit of glue with the toothpick and put it on the flower area. Get a little bit on the stem areas. The flowers are going to be most important. That's the thickest part, so that's probably going to be the easiest part to get it on. And then you just lay it down. And so you see there is some of the white glue that is coming out a little bit, but like I said, that will dry clear, so you don't have to worry about that. I'll just do the second flower here. And I wouldn't even really worry about the stems. I think the flowers are the most important part. As long as there's a good amount of glue on there, I think it'll stick pretty well. So see, I have the flower in front of the butterfly, so I didn't want to have it covered and put it behind it. But you can do a combination. You could do some behind, some in front. So it might be easier to use the tweezers to pick the flowers up. I have pretty long nails, so I'm using those. And just make sure that it's good on the back there. It is also a little bit easier to kind of drag them towards the end. And you really don't need much glue at all. There. And then I just have two kind of smaller flowers. I'll put that right in the middle. This one's pretty delicate. I'm gonna try to pick it up. Oh, and I kind of pinched off a little piece there. The more delicate ones are definitely easier to pick up with the tweezers. I'll just throw that in the corner. So then we're just gonna let that dry a little bit, and then we'll go ahead and put it in our frame. So we'll come back once it's dry. Okay, so I let the flowers dry. We're gonna go ahead and put the botanical scene in the frame now. So if you just flip it over, it does have these tabs that you'll have to pull up. So we'll just do that. If you have rubbing alcohol and you wanna clean down the glass before you put it in, you can do that. So you make sure you don't have any fingerprints or anything. Then you just go ahead and flip that over. And put the back on. Go ahead and push the tabs back down. And then you can hang it or you can just put it on the stand. And there you have it. And that's your framed botanical scene. So I hope you enjoyed this. If you did, please make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Also, don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram, and check out our website, westmontlibrary.org. Thank you. See you next time.